Hello everyone, welcome to our yin and restorative gentle movement yoga session. Let's begin sitting down. Find a way to sit, legs stretched out, both knees bent, sitting on something. And you might even move the flesh aside from your sitting bones, rock a bit side to side, forward and back. And take a moment to feel the surface below your pelvis. Spreading your weight more evenly throughout the bottom of your pelvis so that you can center your spine. And let's place the hands on the rib cage, holding the lowest ribs like you're holding a big jar. Take a deep inhale and lift the lowest ribs, lift the chest. You can even shrug the shoulders, and then as you exhale through the mouth, keep the ribs lifting. Roll your shoulders back and then down, and then rest your hands in your lap. Take another deep breath and press through your two sitting bones and feel the lift up through the center line of your spine, lifting to your crown. And then again, any sound through the mouth, let it go. So just like that, a few more deepening breaths. We can release any sounds that may need to move through. Let your collarbones broaden. Feel the natural space between your chin and chest, softly gliding your chin towards the back of your neck as you lift through the back of your skull. And then notice through any shifts that you may have made through your physical posture, arriving here in this sukhasana or comfortable seated pose, how that might give a little shift in how you feel physically or mentally or energetically. Tuning into those nuances when you experiment with slight shifts in movement, variation of posture, breathing patterns, how that might affect you in your harmonizing of active energy, might be considered yang, and more passive, cooling energy might be considered yin. Here is an excerpt from my yoga psychology teacher, Ashley Turner, defining yoga as yoke, as you might have heard before, or yuj is the root word, and it's the yoking of two complementary, contradictory opposites, hatha. All the practices of yoga are designed to bring us into a greater state of harmony between these dualistic forces of yin, yang, ida, pingala, feminine, masculine. So ida refers to the chandra or the yin, intuitive, feminine energies of the moon, while pingala refers to the surya, yang, logical masculine energies of the sun. These are not gender when we say feminine and masculine. As Guru Sadhguru says, when I say masculine and feminine, I'm not talking in terms of sex or gender, but about being certain qualities in nature. So we have percentages of both qualities. Since there is no perfect symmetry in nature, the aim of yoga is not necessarily to create a perfect balance or equality between yin and yang, but to ride the oscillating waves harmoniously or more harmoniously. That's an interesting thing to point out. We're not looking for exact half and half, but how do we move through the spectrum in harmony? So as you sit here now, noticing perhaps if you feel more active, where it might be physical or energetic or mental, mind is racing or emotions are heavy, or are you feeling more calm, at ease, still, or maybe somewhere in between there? And through this practice of riding those waves more harmoniously, what might you cultivate as your intention? to sitting here now, maybe with the eyes closed. I invite you to set your intention as you honor what is true for you in your body, in your mind, in your heart. Perhaps also dedicating the efforts of this practice for someone or something that you care deeply about. Let's join the hands in prayer at the heart, bowing in as we open this practice, chanting the sound of Om 3 times, helping us to deepen our breaths, create a vibration in the body to help balance the nervous system, and connect in the space that we share. Take a deep inhale. The nose, one more time out through the lips, a gentle whisper. So we'll begin with a pranayama or breathing technique that is geared towards helping to harmonize those left and right hemispheres of the brain and the body associated with the feminine and masculine energies. Nadi shodhana, or alternate nostril breathing. So placing your left hand to rest on your lap, you might choose a mudra to help focus, which is Gyana Mudra, the thumb and index finger to touch, or one that evokes vital energy, Pran Mudra, which is the index and middle fingers straight as the last three fingertips touch. So resting the left hand on your lap, create Vishnu Mudra with your right hand, and that's sticking out your right thumb, pinky, and ring finger. We'll use the right thumb to close off the right nostril, and we'll use the right pinky and ring finger to close off the left nostril as we alternate breathing in and out through each. Closing the eyes if you like, or steadying your gaze softly in one spot ahead. Feel your posture tall, balanced, open. And then closing the lips, let's take a breath to prepare. In through the nose, out through the nose, pause your breath out. Using your right thumb, cover your right nostril, inhale slowly through the left nostril. Pause the breath in. Last two right fingers cover left nostril, exhale gently and slowly through the right. Pause the breath out. Staying here, inhale through the right. Pause the breath in. Cover right with thumb. Exhale gently, slowly through the left. Pause the breath out. And we just finished one cycle of Nadi Shodhana. Let's take a few more. Inhale through the left. Pause. Cover left. Exhale through right. Pause. Inhale through right. pause. Cover right, exhale through left. Pause. We just finished the second round. Take the last three rounds at your own pace. Inhale through left, keep going. Keeping your body relaxed, even as you're holding the breath. Let it be as gentle of a practice as possible, no strain. Feel the full length of each in and out breath. And without rushing, finish those last three rounds on your own. And when you do, bring both of your hands into the same mudra as you sit. Just a moment to pause and observe the effects of that pranayama on your mind, your body, energetic state. And whenever you are ready, let's continue deep breaths through the nose. Inhaling the full length, slowly filling up your belly, your lower back, the four walls of your rib cage. Slightly lifting your sternum without raising the shoulders. And then exhaling just as slowly through the nose, perhaps softly narrowing the back of your throat to create a gentle whispering sound. With that, you're practicing Ujjayi Pranayama, or victorious breathing, which helps to promote a relaxed nervous system while warming up your body, preparing it to move. And if your eyes are closed, softly blink them open. Take a look at your legs if you are sitting cross-legged. I invite you to switch the cross of the leg that's forward or on top. Press your palms face down onto your lap as you root your sitting bones. Take a deep in-breath and lift through the center of your spine while relaxing the shoulders. And then exhale, lean over to your left with your torso before circling your torso forward. Over to the other side, to the pace of your breath and back. So circling your torso. Feeling your pelvis here, your lower back, your sacrum, warming up into that region. And when you feel ready, switch directions. Breathing in, one half the circle. Breathing out, the other half. And let's switch directions again. Maybe the circumference of that circle grows. And one more time, switch directions. Notice how you feel as we bring movement into the spine. For some, it can feel energizing as you're awakening main energy centers that lie throughout the spine, especially here in the mid solar plexus, the lower areas, sacrum, base of the spine. And then as you come back through center, keep sitting tall with the shoulders relaxed. Inhale, sweep your arms up high, reach through the fingertips, and then exhale, open the arms and twist to the left. So arms are like a T, you're not landing them on the ground. You're rotating the ribcage to the left. Inhale, reach your arms up. Maybe the palms touch, maybe they don't. Shoulders stay relaxed. Exhale, seal in the front ribs and twist to the other side. Open your arms like a T. Two more on each side. Inhale, lift up. Think of drawing the navel in and up as you exhale to twist. So get tall as you're twisting. Inhale, center. Exhale, twist. Last round, inhale, lift. And exhale, feel that twist, especially across your waistline. One more, breathe in. And exhale, breathe out. And then coming back to center, we're gonna set ourselves up for a held seated twist. Extending your left leg forward. Choose to either place your right foot on the ground just in front of your right hip, or to place your right foot flat on the ground outside of your left knee, in which you might also bend your left knee. Just find the variation that allows your pelvis to feel evenly grounded, your spine easily tall. And then backstroke your right hand to the floor just behind your pelvis. As you raise your left arm, press into the ground with every part of your body touching it to feel a lift up through your spine. Take a deep breath. The shoulders relaxed, chest open, and exhale, turn your chest to the right, lowering your left arm to either hold your right shin or maybe to eventually hook your left elbow outside of your right thigh. And with each in-breath, press into the ground again to lift up through the center of your spine, keeping your collarbones wide open. Exhale, draw in the belly and continue to rotate your ribcage. And we'll be here for about 8 more breaths, taking your time to feel into what range is available here in your spinal twist. Without overdoing it, not force space, but breathing into it mindfully, phase by phase. Now you might explore how it feels to turn your head if you haven't already, like you're looking over your right shoulder behind you. Can you allow the top of your head to feel stacked above your tailbone? So the spine stays as vertically upright as possible. With your breath, encourage your collarbones to splay wide from the sternum at the middle of your chest to each shoulder head, while softening the tops of your shoulders down. About 3 more breaths. And as you're breathing out, slowly unwind from the twist. Extend your left leg forward if it's not already. And you may want to grab a strap as we come into half cow face pose, taking your right thigh to cross over the left thigh so that perhaps you can stack your knees down your midline. Flexing your left foot, if you are using a strap, step the ball of your left foot into the loop or just the middle of the strap, holding it with enough slack so that you're able to rest the shoulders back and down. If you don't have a strap, place your hands on the floor here. And then take a couple of breaths, lugging the sitting bones down, lifting up through your spine, drawing the navel slightly towards the back as you open the chest, even lifting the back ribs, and conscious of keeping this open space at your throat for the breath to evenly pass through, begin to hinge forward from your hips, little by little, for about 10 breaths. Keep flexing your left foot here, pressing the mound of your left big toe forward into the strap. And then notice to what degree you can bow forward while keeping the spine open, especially at the neck, shoulders relaxed. About three more deep breaths here in Ardha Gomukhasana. Now as the belly firms in to support your lower back, try to maintain the feeling of a flat back. Think of lifting from your chest as you inhale to slowly rise. Put the strap aside. Slide your right leg forward on the ground. And let's set up for the twist as similarly as you did on the first side. So left foot is either in front of the hip, cross outside of your right knee. You might also bend the right knee. Notice your two sitting bones even, spine upright, and then place your left hand just behind your pelvis. Raise your right arm, press into the ground, take a deep breath and lift up through your spine. Exhale, rotate your chest to the left. Lower your right arm to hold your left shin or to hook your left elbow outside of your thigh, your right elbow outside your thigh. Then again, inhale to root down and rise up, keeping the shoulders relaxed. As you exhale, feel your belly soften. Continue to rotate your rib cage. About eight more cycles of breath here. And notice which way you want to turn your head here to help balance off what you did on the first side. Can you feel the alignment of crown of your head stacking above your tailbone, optimizing an upright, spacious spine. And notice the pattern in your breath. Can you still hear it? Then as you're ready to, with an exhale, slowly unwind your spine, straightening your right leg forward, cross the left thigh over the right, stacking your knees down your center. Take the strap if you're using one, place it around the ball of your right foot flexed. Hold the strap with enough slack so shoulders are back and down. Take a couple of breaths, rooting into the floor and sitting up a little taller. Highlighting this openness at your chest and throat. And then as you're ready, as the belly gently firms in, start to hinge little by little from your hips. Imagine you're trying to maintain sort of a flat back. with a slight lift of your chest. And as your right foot is flexed, press into the strap with the ball, big toe mound of your right foot. Let's finish off three more breaths here. As the belly continues to support the back, drawing it in, lead with your chest. Inhale, slowly rise up. Now let's put the strap aside for now as we crawl down onto hands and knees. Setting up for a few rounds of cat-cow. Have your knees a couple inches behind your hips. Choose how to place your hands if you want to stretch the inner sides of your wrists and forearms. Spin out your hands whatever degree they'll spin out. You can also choose to create fists, like giving yourself a fist bump, and gently lean the backs of your fists into the floor. Gets into the outer wrist, or maybe take a few cat-cows in each. And when you're ready, use the inhale to draw your chest through your upper arms, rolling your shoulders back as you lift your heart and gaze. And as you exhale, contract your belly, feel your tailbone tuck underneath, dropping your head to round. Several more cycles at the pace of your own breath. The exhale draws the belly in as you bow, and the inhale floats the heart forward, then up. And then finish off a couple more cycles here of cat-cow or Bidalasana. So that on your second exhalation, with your index fingers both pointing forward, fingers spread, you tuck your toes and spend a few breaths in your version of downward facing dog, where you could pedal your feet slowly in place, just helping to gently loosen up the calves and hamstrings. Perhaps if you're pedaling, you also swivel your hips left and right, opening your outer hips and the sides of your waist. And to help release the neck, you can shake and nod your head. You might also relax the jaw by fluttering your lips, stretching your mouth, sticking out the tongue, and exhaling a sound like lion's breath. Ha! Take about five more breaths, shifting in your own way, in your version of downward facing dog. You open up space across your shoulders, rotating the outer sides of your upper arms towards the floor, and lifting your shoulders back, just like your hips, freeing up space in your neck. Now when you decide you're finished with downward dog, slowly walk your hands back towards your feet, bending your knees deeply as you fold over your legs. And then once there, with knees very bent, shift your weight towards the front of your heels as you spread your toes. The feet are parallel, at least hips distance apart. Catch hold of opposite elbows and begin to sway your spine gently side to side. Inhaling through the mouth, exhaling. Inhaling, and again through the mouth. Switch the cross of your elbows on top, and let's take a couple last breaths here. And then bend your knees a little bit more. Drop your arms, loosen up your neck, shoulders, let the head hang freely. And with knees bent, draw the navel in towards your spine. And with an inhalation, very slowly stack one vertebra at a time. So you're rolling up to stand, lifting your head last. Take your time here. And when you do rise all the way, shrug your shoulders on another inhalation. And as you open the mouth to exhale, roll your shoulders back, turn your palms to face forward, and release the shoulders down, mountain pose. Spread your toes and feel your weight press down through the four corners of each foot, activating the arches of your feet, the front muscles of your thighs, gently your belly, as you lift up through the back of your skull and open your chest, free the shoulders. As you inhale, sweep your arms overhead, take hold of your left wrist with your right hand. And as you exhale, begin to side bend to your right, pressing the left foot heavier into the floor. As the belly firms in to help you, inhale, rise to center, take hold of the right wrist with your left hand. Exhale, side bend to your left, pressing the right foot heavier onto the floor. Let's take two more on each side. Inhale, center, switch hands. Exhale, side bend to the right. Inhale, center, hold the right wrist. Exhale, side bend to the left. Last one, inhale, center, hold the left wrist. Exhale, side bend to the right. Inhale, center, hold the right wrist. Exhale, side bend to the left. And then inhale back to center, bend your left elbow and bring your left palm towards the space right between your shoulder blades. Using your right hand, rotate the left tricep or outer upper arm slightly more to face forward as you plug both shoulders down, bringing the elbow towards the back of your head. Reach the right hand underneath. Walk your hands as close together as you can. And if they don't meet to clasp, you can take the strap, dangle it from your left hand, and then catch hold of it underneath with the right hand, walking your hands as close together as you can. And then from here, root the left foot heavier into the floor again. Breathe up the center of your spine as you hug your front ribs in. Keep the shoulders down and relax and begin to side bend to your right for about 5 breaths in total. Inhaling to lift the spine from the pelvis a bit more. And exhaling, continue to side bend. Can you honor the open space between your chin and chest and throughout your neck? Last breath here. And draw the navel in. Inhale, rise up to center. Exhale, release your arms and shake them out. So here, raise your right arm up, bend the elbow, place the palm towards the area right between your shoulder blades. Use your left hand, rotate the right outer upper arm forward. Draw the right elbow towards the center of your head, then reach the left hand underneath. If the hands do not clasp, hand your right hand the strap so it's hanging from above, and then grab the other end of it from underneath with your left hand. With hands as close together as possible, root down especially through your right foot and inhale up the center of your spine. Keep the shoulders relaxed, hug the front ribs in. Exhale, begin to side bend to the left. Inhale, lift the spine from your pelvis some more, keep the right foot heavy. Exhale, side bend to the left. About 3 more breaths. Feel your throat open for your breath to flow. And as you firm the lower belly in, inhale, rise up to center. Exhale, release both arms, shake them out. Root down to your feet. Inhale, circle your arms overhead. Watch your palms meet. Bend your knees any amount. Exhale, open the arms like a swan dive. Bow in. Press your legs to the ground. Inhale, draw your chest forward, halfway rise. Exhale, fold again. Press through your feet. Inhale, sweep your arms as you rise. Palms meet, look up. Exhale, tracing your midline, bring the arms down by your sides. Again, inhale, sweep your arms overhead. Separate the arms. Exhale, dive into a forward fold. Press with the hands. Inhale, lengthen your spine forward. Exhale, fold in. Press to your feet. Inhale, circle the arms. Look up, palms touch. Tracing your midline with your thumbs. Exhale into mountain pose. Last round of Ardha Surya Namaskar. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, open the arms and fold. Exhale, rise halfway. Excuse me, inhale, rise halfway. And exhale, fold. Inhale, sweep your arms, rise all the way. Tracing your midline, exhale, bring the hands down your center. And then from here, let's come down to our knees as we set up for our restorative pose. Placing your pillow right across your mat here, towards the front of the mat. And this is a opening for the chest, the inner shoulders. Some call it the melting heart asana. So we're going to extend the arm, keeping the hips right above the knees. Slightly draw the belly in so that you can maintain the feeling of a flat back. As you start to bow, extending your arms forward, rotate your triceps towards the ground. So you want to feel this broadening across your shoulders. And the palms can be slightly turned up, like you're trying to catch a basketball. Or you can press your five fingertips into each other. And then you can space your knees further from the pillow or closer to the pillow so that you're able to lower your head, whatever amount it will lower. So you want to feel mostly your elbows, maybe your upper arms pressing into the pillow. So you feel your chest sinking or melting towards the ground. As you're rotating the outer sides of your upper arms towards the ground, keeping the tops of the shoulders wide open. And then find a slight lift of the belly here towards the lower back, supporting it so it's not dumping down towards the earth. Feel that your hips stack above your knees. Take a few breaths, centering into the side ribs, stretching the intercostal muscles between them. Feeling the full length of in-breath, match out-breath. And I'm going to set the clock here for another minute and a half. Notice the spacing between your elbows and try to keep them your shoulders distance apart, not wider apart than that, to help keep the shoulders broad. Feel into your facial muscles, relaxing your tongue, your jaw, muscles around your eyes and behind your eyes. Relaxing the skin on your forehead. Plug your upper arm bones back into your shoulder sockets, away from your neck. That stability in the shoulders. We're down to 20 more seconds here. Breathe. Tamasoma Jyotir Gamaya. All right, slowly begin to sink into child's pose. A few breaths, just transitioning out here. So let your pelvis meet your heels. You can rest your arms down by your legs if you like, just for a counter posture. You might like to turn your head to one side or place your forehead on the ground. Take about 5 breaths here into your nose and long exhales to your mouth. If you're turning your head to one side, switch sides to help even out the stretch in your neck. 2 more breaths. And as you plant your hands on the floor beside your knees, inhale to roll your spine upright. And we'll set up for the next posture, which is sort of a counter posture, opening up across the backs of the shoulders and the upper back. The legs are going to be similar to child's pose. The thighs are just slightly wider apart than hips distance, if that's available. But keep your pelvis as close to your feet as possible. And then you'll have blocks nearby just in case you might use it for your head. So this is a version of thread the needle, sometimes called tadpole pose. So placing your left fingertips on the floor, like in front of your left knee. Thread your right arm underneath your left elbow, so your right palm is face up. And then lower the right side of your head all the way down. Now, if it doesn't comfortably meet the ground, then take one of your pillows and place it right underneath your head for support. And so as you're flaring the left elbow towards the sky, you can press the ground with your left fingertips. Or you might choose to wrap your left arm behind your back, perhaps tucking your right fingertips, your left fingertips, on the top of your right thigh, just holding onto it, if that's available. So experiment with what variation works for you that your body might need here right now. And I'll set the timer for 2 minutes before we switch sides in this pose. Land your awareness back on your breath, riding the waves of inhale and exhale, energizing breath in and calming breath out. Notice that your shoulders are adequate space away from your ears. Your neck has freedom here. Feel into the effect of this pose. How might it affect you energetically? Let's take one last breath here. And as you exhale, gently press the ground with your left hand to slowly rise. Sit up for a moment, couple of breaths. Just feel your spine neutralize before we switch sides. Then planting your right fingertips about a foot away from your right knee, forward of it. Thread your left arm underneath your right elbow with the left palm face up. Keep your hips close to your heels as you lower the left side of your head all the way on the ground or onto block. And feel the breath open up into the backs of your lungs, directing the breath there right across the upper back, shoulder blades, the tops of the shoulders, into the side ribs. We're also here for 2 minutes. Noticing your breath here. You have about 30 more seconds. Take one last deep breath. And as you exhale, slowly press yourself upright to sit. Let's lay the legs out in front of you this time. Just let them extend forward for a moment. You can even roll your thighs inward and outward or shake out your legs. But as you place your hands alongside your hips, help to ground your pelvis evenly. Draw the shoulder head slightly behind the ears and down, and then as you inhale, drop your chin towards your chest. Slowly rolling your head to one shoulder, taking it all the way around into a circle for a few breaths. Very slowly, very gently, circling your head a couple of times in one direction. At your pace, then a couple of times in the opposite direction. Feel the part of your neck that really lengthens with each shift, each movement. You might imagine breathing into that outstretched part of your neck. Notice what your lower back and belly are doing here. Lengthen from the bottom of your spine up. And then as you finish those total of 4 cycles, come upright to sit. We'll put the pillow aside where you can reach it for Shavasana in a moment. Please grab a block. Come to lie down on your back with your knees bent. As you step your feet on the ground, lift your hips and slide the block across your sacrum underneath the flat part of your lower back. And then take a moment here to really situate the block so you can completely balance your pelvis, on it, your lower back on it, so that you can extend your legs straight up. You can bend your knees here, so let your legs relax as they're upright. Your hands rest, palms face down onto your lower belly, draw the shoulders down the back. And let's finish off another 8 abdominal breaths. So you're breathing into your belly with your hands, feeling the belly expand and gently rise. And as you exhale through the mouth, feel the belly soften, sinking towards the spine. Abdominal breathing helps digestion to flow, helps to calm the nervous system, relax the mind and body. Hear the breath gently release through your lips. And this posture, elevating the hips higher than the heart as the legs are lifted, promotes healthy blood flow and digestive flow. Notice how your body might be responding right now in this posture for the last few breaths. Notice how it might be affecting your energetic state, or mental, emotional. And as you finish off one last breath or two, take the time to gently step 1 foot at a time onto the ground. And with both feet pressing into the floor, lift your hips and gently remove the block, lowering your spine completely. Take your pillow and slide it across the mat underneath the backs of your knees. And you can either lay flat, head on the floor, or if you want a little more lift in the chest, take a block or 2 blocks. 1 block, lowest height, rearmost edge of your mat. 2nd block, medium height, crossing the mat, where you can land the area right under your shoulder blade tips onto that slightly higher block, and the back of your head on the lower block. If this feels too much of a lift in the chest, then tilt the block under your head to the same height as the one under your shoulders, shoulder blades. Now you might feel comfortable bending the elbows apart, letting the backs of the hands rest on the ground. Just make sure your shoulders are away from your ears here. They don't feel like they're shrugging. Balance in the left and right hips, left and right shoulders. And then take a few last breaths from the soles of your feet up the center line of your body to your crown. Exhaling from crown down the spine, out through the soles of your feet. And as you're ready, release control of your breath. Close your eyes and embrace stillness. Embrace not doing for a few minutes of rest. Gently begin to rub your thumbs across your fingertips, softly moving your skull as you feel your neck release. Point, flex your feet, rotate at your ankles, and ease into raising your arms, drawing your bent knees into your chest. Slowly turn to your right side, resting your head. Tuning in, perhaps keeping your eyes closed as you're ready, press the ground to rise into a comfortable seat for our 5 minutes silent in meditation. Now, here are a couple of suggestions for your meditation practice. You might opt to soften your awareness on the rise and fall of your breath, breathing naturally. Perhaps visualizing the in-breath start at the base of your spine, rising to your crown, and visualizing the out-breath descending from your crown down your spine to the base. Or you can focus on the chant of Om, as you might hear in the background now, repeating. You can even choose to chant out loud or chant internally, mentally, feeling the vibration of the sound through the music. So choosing your practice, I've set the timer for 5 minutes. Gently slide your palms to meet at your heart center, bowing in. Closing this practice with a reminder. To bring that practice of harmonizing between the oscillating waves of yin and yang in your everyday life. Notice when you're veering really close to one end of the spectrum and how that affects you physically, energetically, mentally, emotionally. You have the tools of yoga practice. Notice what might be useful to apply. With that, let's close with one chant of Om. Take a deep breath. The light in me bows to the light in you. Namaste.